Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi wahda wa salatu wa salamu ala man la nabiyya ba'dah. Dear respected viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to another brand new episode of the program entitled Towards the Origin Watch, live on Channel S, Sky 734. Inshallah, this program will also be broadcasted live on the Facebook page, and later on, inshallah, there will be a repeat of this program on the following day on this very channel, and also you'll find us on our YouTube channel. Tonight's discussion is on the topic, Islam, a source of education. The world that we live in today, unfortunately, we find ourselves in a bit of challenging situation. We are challenged at every corner. Yet, when we read the history of Islam, when we read the history of the companions and the tabi'eens and the tabi'eens, we find out the gems of that time till today who are recognized in the field of Islam, in the field of fiqh, in the field of jurisprudence, alhamdulillah, they are all from the faith of Islam. Not only restricted to only fiqhi and shari'i perspective, but also in the scientific advancement, we do find the Muslims had always led the field. So what has happened today? Why are we not following the history that we once had a glory? All of this and many more, inshallah, we'll be trying our level best to discuss and touch on these kind of topic. And inshallah, we'll try and find out about the difference in education that we have in our current modern society, which is the secular and Islamic education. Now, to discuss this topic, we have been joined with our regular guest, who is the respected Imaam and Khateeb of London Central Mosque and Islamic Cultural Centre based in Regent's Park, Fadilatul Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you very much for joining with us so late at night once again.
My pleasure. Jazakallah khairan.
Now, let's start. The topic title is Islam, a source of education. Now, let us understand the term education, and most importantly, in today's world that we live in, there is a completely two different set of education, whether you see it, especially in the Muslim land, where we have a different schools and different syllabuses, whether it be an Islamic school, which is commonly known as madrasa, or the secular education. Within the secular education, you've got the Bangla education, or whichever the mother tongue of the country is, if you are talking about the subcontinent, and you also have then English medium school. Mm-hmm. Now, how do you understand, or how would you make our viewers and myself understand the subject of the topic education? How would you define
طيب. it? Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil anbiya wal mursaleen, nabiyyina Muhammad ibn Abdullah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi at-tayyibin at-tahirin, wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsan ila yawmiddin, rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri, wahlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. After praising Allah and sending salam and salutations to the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. He is one and he has no partners. And I also testify that the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger and slave of Allah, the Almighty. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, and by his mercy and by his bounties, he chose the best prophet for the Ummah of Islam. Allah pak rabbul alaminer oshom oshesh korunay uni amaderke srishti korechen ebong amader jonno shobtheke bhalo ebong uttom nabi amader jonno selection korechen. And then we also find Allah the Almighty, he chose the best book, Al-Quran al-Karim, the living miracle of the noble prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as a guide and as a navigation for the Ummah of Islam.
Now, living medical, johan apni bolen, how would you understand? How shall a person who does not follow Islam fully, or who has questions about Islam, how can they understand?
Because Quran, the whole entire book itself is miracle in many, many different ways, and it's proven. And there are so many things proven by the scholars and scientists and Muslim scholars, and even the scholars who are outside Islam, proved that Quran is a book of miracle, and it's you know, it's proven in many, many different ways.
Okay, you mean to say that in a scientific perspective, or
in a scientific perspective, okay, linguistic perspective, okay, meanings and things that Quran predicted and mentioned before the advancement and before the discovery of many, many things, many technology in the modern time. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he created the book Al-Quran Al-Kareem for the Ummah of Islam, and that is the most genuine, authentic book that ever existed. Now, when Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he began the communication with the noble prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, jakon Allah pak rabbul alamin unar priyo nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam shata jini koto pukoton communication jakon shuru koren, tokon first jinishta ki chilo, what was the first thing that he started off with? So Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he began the communication, and the first thing he ever said was a word called iqra. Now, what do we understand from the word iqra? Iqra means to read. As if Allah Ta'ala is teaching Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and saying that, you know, you and your ummah are the people of reading, people of knowledge, people of education. To me, hey Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ummatra shikkar jati, shikkar prashunar jati, lekhapurar jati, knowledge jati. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he chose the first word to be iqra. Can you imagine?
Now,
the Quran begins not talking about the Jannah and Jahannam and Akhirah and all those, but it begins with the word iqra, which means to read.
Now, just want to understand here, such a profound word, according to the way you have described and the way Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is talking about it. Now, atsker shomaje dekha jay ei je shobdo iqra ekhon hoye geche byabshar protishthan nam hoye geche bachchader nam hoye geche charity organization nam mani ekhon bibhinno jaygay apni jekhanei dekhben musalmanra kono dhoroner tijarar sathe jukto achen ekhon ei shobdo ta eto byabohrito hocche je actual term ta ki amra ekhono eta bujhte parchi.
Right now, I think people are deriving the names from the word iqra because it's very noble and because it's from Quran al-Kareem. So people have a good intention behind choosing the names. But yes, it should promote, or the name or the organizations should promote the iqra, meaning to read and to study and to educate, because everything goes back to education. So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has, he began the Quran actually by the word iqra. And really, when he said iqra, he just didn't say read. He said, let's just read the surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Read in the name of your Lord. Or tumar probur name poro. Because if you read and it's not guided by the revelation, wahi, or the wahi that I can guide noy, tokon ki hobe, people can easily get lost and get confused and can get into things and deviated from the correct understanding.
Now, many a times, translation of dekha jay je iqra, do you think it's fully accordingly translated? Karon onek jagay recite bola ache, abar onek jagay translation e read bola ache.
Not really. There's not much big difference. Recite is just to perform, and read is just to read.
So recite, is it not with understanding?
Yeah. So read, you read, and when you recite, you read in a very good way, in an artistic way, in a nice and beautiful voice.
Now, what I'm trying to look at is when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or when the Quran was revealed, the iqra does it refer to only read and recite, or does it also mean to understand?
Of course,
to comprehend.
No, definitely.
To
when somebody asks you to read, then definitely that means to understand, because read and understand.
The reason why I say that, because then when it comes to reading, you can read a novel, you can read a book, but yeah, perhaps you might not even necessarily need to understand. You just need to find out what's the conclusion of that book,
yes,
or what the author is trying to say.
Quran should be read with reflection and pondering. Quran Sharif kintu amaderke gobeshonar sathe porte hobe ebong understanding sathe porte hobe. But that doesn't mean that to recite doesn't have any rewards, because reciting also is highly rewarding. It's a separate ibadah, worship. Now, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. Read in the name of your Lord. Tumar probur name poro. Why? Because if it's not led and guided by the revelation, wahi, then people will easily be misguided. And so therefore, education is highly important, but with the guidance of علم الوحي, the knowledge of revelation. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, خلق الإنسان من علق. Reminding Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the people and human beings that Allah the Almighty created human beings from clot. Allah pak rabbul alamin ekta rokto pindo theke manushderke srishti korechen. Just this is our origin. Khalaq al insan.
Is that the miracle you were talking about?
Again, yes. This is one of the miracles of Quran, because it's really proven at this time, after all of those the camera and screening and these things.
Scientific advancement.
Mm. But Quran did speak about the embryology, human embryology, 1440 years back. Then we see iqra wa rabbuka al akram. Poro tumar rob kintu could be the Kornamoy. Your Lord is very generous and kind. Then it says, Alladhi allama bil qalam, that the one who taught you with the pen. So pen also plays an important role in the Islamic education. So this is the reason why even the scholars of Islam say, like, respect whatever you have, like, show your honor and respect to the tools of education. So even the pen, you should respect the pen, because Quran al-Karim speaks highly of the pen. So you see, there's a surah in the Noble Quran, which is Surah Al-Qalam. So he taught with the pen. And then he said, عَلَّمَ الْإِنسَانَ مَا لَمْ يَعْلَمْ. Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala taught people, human beings, what they never knew, what they didn't know. Today, sometime, when we have knowledge, we have arrogance and pride and we boast, right? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, you didn't know these things. Amader moddhe ahankar, gorob, gorbo, chole ashe jokhon amader moddhe kichu shikkha dike chole ashe. Ebong there is a saying, bangla ekta kotha ache je alpo bidya bhoyongkori, little knowledge is dangerous. So ejonno আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন উনি আমাদের শিক্ষা দিয়েছেন, এজন্য গৌরবের কোনো কারণ নেই। বাট আমরা যতই শিক্ষা দীক্ষা লাভ করি এই পৃথিবীর মধ্যে, we always will be still limited because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another verse, وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا, that you have been given only a small little amount of knowledge.
Now, knowledge
doesn't matter how big you become, there'll be still things you don't know.
Now, ikhane je apni bolche utito mane ilm illa qali, ikhane je ilm eta ki shudhu ilm ki bole revelation er kotha bola holche
na, no, general knowledge guidance. In general knowledge, because no matter how big engineer you become, how big doctor you become, how big alim you become, how big scholar and faqih you become, jurist, still there'll be stuff that you didn't know. I was just listening earlier. A great scholar known as Sheikh Abdul Fattah Abu Ghudda was a great Syrian scholar. He said that, you know, when he was asked, who are your teachers? He said, my teachers, so-and-so-and-so. Amar shikokder moddhe unara. Kintu tarpor bolchen, my teachers are also my students. Okay. And he said, I learned things from my students that I never learned from my teachers. And he said, like, you should be open to knowledge, because some of the things that you can learn from your students that you have never learned from maybe from your teachers.
Now, ekhane ekti cultural barrier ache. Problem hotse je, when you see, how can a teacher say, ami amader samajer kotha bolchi je ami shikshok hoye ami kemne boli je ami student er kach theke shikchi.
Ejonno jader kintu jara really shikshabid, jara really gyani, oi gyani byakti gulo kintu khubi humble thake. They have to be really humble. One of them ekta jiyase a pride arrogance takte parbe na.
Tar mani hotche apni bolte chaacchen je hoyto uni janen, but hoyto emon bhabe uni prokash korben onar motke ba onar mani the indication that he may give je uni ashole janen na ebong khub monojog shohokare shunchen ebong shikchen, as opposed to ajke amra dekhi samaje je amra ektu jodi shike feli, as if like we have learned the whole subject.
Exactly, yes, that's true. And this is the real problem, disease we have. So I remember another scholar, a great scholar known as Sheikh Muhammad Mutawalla Sha'rawi from Egypt. He also said that al-alim huwa alladhi la yash'uru bi annahu alim. A true scholar is the one who doesn't feel that he's a scholar. You always go to him, he'll tell you, no, I'm not a scholar, I don't know much. He doesn't feel that he's a scholar. العالم الذي لا يشعر بأنه عالم. So علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. Then Allah تبارك وتعالى also created mankind, but he didn't leave them without teaching the knowledge. He gave them the basic, essential, fundamental knowledge while they're growing, they're, you know, coming to the world. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught the mankind the speech. And many things. وَعَلَّمَكَ مَا لَمْ تَكُنْ تَعْلَمْ. Allah taught you what you didn't know. And numerous oshonko ogonito Quran al-Karim er ayat al-mudde manushterke Allah pakrabana kibu shikka diyechen ebon kibu dikka diyechen ei jinish kola Allah pakrabala ami mention korechen. Then we find Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also, he tells and orders the ummah, the people, to seek knowledge and to get actively engaged. To engage actively in seeking knowledge. And so he says very clearly, طَلَبُ الْعِلْمِ فَرِيضَ عَلَى كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ. That seeking knowledge, it's a compulsory action upon every Muslim. Now, when we say Muslim, that of course includes the Muslim as well. When we say man, it also includes the women. Because anything that's completely, that's mandatory, compulsory in Islam, that's also mandatory for, for men, it's also mandatory for women. Unless there is a specific text or verse specifies that this is only for men or this is only for women. So Prophet ﷺ said, طلب العلم فريضة على كل مسلم. The seeking knowledge is a must, compulsory upon every single Muslim man and woman.
Jara bolen cultural onek practice dekhechi jara murubbir hoyto bolen meyder ke eto beshi poranor dorkar nei. What would your message be towards them?
I think there is nothing as such that, you know, there's not a difference between men and women when it comes to education.
Acquiring education.
Mm. But perhaps some people speak due to the situation and the circumstance and how it's being taught and how and things. So that's maybe that could be the reason for why some talk, some people speak.
Should they not discipline their son then?
Yeah, and of course, that's right. But at the same time, I think our people, we should be setting the institutions and educational centers which are suitable for
catering both
catering,
the genders.
Yes, okay. Correctly and properly and suitably, so that it doesn't really cause destruction to our young generation rather than education.
Is it because if we can get a mother educated, the children will be...
Of course, okay. Yes. And we'll talk a little bit like, you know, how women scholars in Islam, how they contributed to the world education as well.
Okay.
We'll touch upon that. So, طلب العلم فريضة على كل مسلم ومسلمة. Essential knowledge, fundamental knowledge is a must and is fard upon every single Muslim man and woman. This is Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam talking. Prottek musliman noro nari dupor gyan ilmer gyan orjon kora foraj. Tarpore we see that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala also, he gives preference to the people of knowledge over the people of ignorance. He gives preference to the people of knowledge over the people of not knowledge.
How?
So Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, he is talking in the Quran and he's saying, right, قل say, O Muhammad, هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون? Those who know and those who do not know, can they be equal? Can they be same? جارا جانه ابن جارا جانه نا تراكي شمانو تباري. Allah Pakar Bala Alameen is asking, questioning.
In what context are we referring as equal?
So can they, like the people who don't, who know and who do not know, can they be really same in the sense that, you know, understanding, the basira, idraq, understanding, knowledge, can they really be same? But of course not, because the people who know, they are different to the people who do not know.
You mean people life who are qualified,
yes,
are more aware of things than people who might not be?
Yes.
Okay, yes.
And then so Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Only the verily the people of intellect take the reminders. إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب. People of knowledge, people of intellect, people of intelligence, they take the reminders. إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب.
Now, এখানে কিন্তু আরেক প্রশ্ন জাগে. That many people might say or might argue that অনেক মানুষের কিন্তু intellect আছে, knowledge আছে, wisdom আছে, but it does not reflect into his action or her action,
yeah,
and it does not, yes, manifest into
true
action. Just have knowledge.
And unfortunately, this is the scenario that we see at this time of the world.
Let me give an example. Every Muslim know that praying salah is mandatory. There's no if and but about it if you have your senses and if you're physically able. Even if you're not, then we know what are the ahkam on that as well. But still, we will find people has the knowledge, but we'll see they do not pray
again,
themselves.
Like,
for an instance,
so
just give
in
an example.
In Islam, really, knowledge doesn't count unless it's practiced, it's applied. And this is the reason why Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, he spoke about the people before us. He said, مَثَلِ الَّذِينَ حُمِّلُوا التَّوْرَاةَ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَحْمِلُوهَا كَمَثَلِ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُوا أَسْفَارًا. The people before us, they used to carry the books, they used to have a lot of knowledge and they never practiced. And then Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala said, this is just an example of like donkey carrying a lot of books. So it's like a donkey is carrying a huge amount of books, but he doesn't, or the donkey doesn't know anything.
And on the other side, on the other side, flip side of the example could be, there are scholars who would preach, propagate, and tell things that they personally wouldn't do it themselves in their own life.
Yeah.
How would you look into
that? Again, like, so, of course, we
as, with due respect, of course, I'm not singling out anyone.
As, of course, preachers and scholars and ulama and imams and others, those who speak and encourage the people. This is also a way actually to take the encouragement and motivation, because sometimes when you speak and tell others, that's a reminder for ourselves and for themselves. So I think like there should be always আমাদেরকে সব সময় কিন্তু আমরা চেষ্টা রাখতে হবে, আমাদেরকে সব সময় আমাদের আপ্রাণ চেষ্টা করতে হবে যে আমাদের apply করার জন্য এবং আমাদেরকে আমল করার জন্য যে কাজগুলো always should be transformed into the action. And this is not only just Islamic knowledge, but also the knowledge, the secular and worldly knowledge. If we know something, then let's just apply in our life. And many things that are taught by Islam, agreed by the common sense and the nature and fitra of people. And so therefore, when we know something, it must be applied. And that happened in the history and in the past. Mm. But today, like sometimes we are highly educated, but we have a lot of lackings and we don't apply our knowledge.
Not only that, Abhi, jodi ekta basic level e dekhen, amra jokhon meeting attend kori, professional meeting, if we are supposed to attend at 9 o'clock, we are there 5 or 10 minutes or 15 minutes perhaps before the actual meeting starts. Mm. But very same thing, apni jokhon ekta dawat diyechen, biyer dawat diyechen, ba apni ekta functional dawat diyechen, the very same people who attend the meeting on time, you would find them attending their own family meeting, family gathering, family commitment.
Then it should be, of course, there need to be really improvement on those sides, and Muslims need to improve as well to be kind of like maintain the timing. And of course, time is highly important in Quran and in Islam. And Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he really spoke and gave importance to every minute and every second.
So when you then referring to the verse, قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِ الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ, that means it not only applies to people who are intellectual, but intellectual with manifestation.
So قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ, those who practice, because the ones who know, they're expected to practice, expected to apply. If they don't apply, then there's no point, because there's no benefit of the knowledge. And Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he seek refuge. He said, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min 'ilmin la yanfa'. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you to protect me from the knowledge that doesn't benefit. And the knowledge which is not applied is not beneficial.
And so, just before you move on, I want to touch on sharing this knowledge. Say, for instance, even you know one verse, even if you know one secular knowledge or whatever the knowledge is, how important is it to share?
Yes, no, of course, knowledge needs to be shared and it needs to be spreaded, because Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and Islam generally says to spread the knowledge, because it demands to be spread. And talabul ilmi farida, and you know, and go out, balighu anni wala aya, go and spread. All of those things are there in Islam, and encouraging highly to spread the knowledge. So and then Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he also says and he considers that people of knowledge have been given a lot of goodness. So the people who have been given knowledge, the understanding of the deen, they have been given much goodness and much khair. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "Man yuridi Allahu bihi khayran yufaqihu fi din." Whomsoever is given the understanding of religion, or whomsoever Allah wishes the goodness for him or her, Allah gives him or her the understanding of deen. "Man yuridi Allahu bihi khayran yufaqihu fi din." So these people are the people of goodness, because they've been granted and they've been given the knowledge. Jadirki Allah pak rabbul alamin ilmi wahir gyan den, jaderke Allah pak rabbul alamin diner shikha ebong diner gyan dan koren, taderke onek bhalo jinish dan koren.
Onek shomoy manusher lokera bolte pare je hoyto tar baba take madrasay poriyechilo, tar baba take islami shikha diyechilo, dar jonno she hoyto mufassir hoyeche, faqih hoyechen. What would you say on that?
মানে বাবা
বাবা তাকে বাবা মা হয়তো তাকে মাদ্রাসা বা ইসলামিক স্কুলে ভর্তি করেছেন বলে সে আজকে ইসলামিক স্কলার হয়েছে বা কোরআনের জ্ঞানী হয়েছে.
ওকে, রাইট নাও দেন अगेन दिस there is a luck in it, there is a qadar in it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
destiny.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose that person to be there. Otherwise, even the parents sent the child, he would come back. But অনেক ছেলেমেয়েদেরকে কিন্তু মাদ্রাসায় দেওয়া হয়, ইসলামিক প্রতিষ্ঠানে দেওয়া হয়, কিন্তু সে থাকে না, সে চলে আসে.
আর আমাদের দেশের কালচারে কিন্তু দেখা যায় যে দ্য পার্সন হু ইজ দ্য লিস্ট ইকুইপড ইন টার্মস অফ personal development, in terms of academic development.
Yeah, I mean, this is unfortunate. And then we expect the best results from the
madrasa, correct.
From the madrasa people. And so I think we need to, and alhamdulillah, it's changing right now. So I think we need to choose the most intellectual ones to be sent to the madrasa, to the Islamic institution.
Are you trying to say, jebhabe amra ekta cheler madrasa jodi
there should be equality.
Honor thake, quality thake, we look into medicine and engineering, law, field.
Yes. And I see people say, oh, okay, you know, my son was really unwell and he had a struggle in many ways, and then inshallah, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep him alive, we'll send him to madrasa.
Okay.
See, it's the charity. Okay. So, but now we need to change that, and then amaderke kintu amader ei ei chinta dhara gulo ke amaderke poriborton korte hobe. Shudhu mane je cheleme gulo oshustho hoye pore, je cheleme gulo mane oder onek life
learning difficulty thakte pare,
amra bole thaki je oderke amra madrasay diye dibo, kintu jokhon ekta chele ba ekta me mane khub intelligent, khubi
shukko ebong
khubi medhabi, oderke kintu amra boli je amra university dibo, amader college ke dibo. College at least there should be equality. I'm not saying that, you know, it should be the other way round completely, but there should be a kind of equality. We should send equally our children to Islamic institution as well as the
we have many examples, alhamdulillah, in this society living in the Western culture. Amader bahu, even within my friend circle, I've seen the doctors, the alim, and the hafiz as well. So, alhamdulillah, we've seen examples of this in this country, combining the medical science and Islam as an alim and the hafiz of Quran. But maybe perhaps we don't see much of it in the subcontinent region.
I think this is also changing somehow, maybe in some places. But there should be more changes in the Muslim world. I think we really need to combine between the Islamic knowledge and the secular knowledge.
Now, my dear brother, a very excellent message that has come across from Sheikh, and that is there has to be balance and fairness, and we have to ensure that we give our due rights to our children, and not only the most vulnerable of our children should be going to the madrasa, but also the most intellectual of our children should also be looking forward to those Islamic institutions, and then that's when we can look forward to a better change in the society. Inshallah, we'll continue our discussion, but after a short break. Do stay tuned. You're watching Towards the Origin. Wassalamu alaikum.